guys, Arwen here, and this is your weekly reading for July 4th through the 10th of 2016. And I felt guided to use the Faery Oracle, the Wild Wisdom of the Faery Oracle by Lucy Cavendish. Alrighty. I just saw this card deck in my head as I was meditating on which one we would use for this week. So the first card is... Wait, I think this was the first card. Yes. The first card is Keeper of the Secrets, and I realize this is a little light on the screen, but it's a very pale fairy, and she's got like a kind of a shawl around her, and she's holding a key. And what this card said is, use your discernment, confide in a trusted friend, keep silent about knowledge. So as I move into this card, the first thing that I notice about it is there's a lot of pink frequencies, right? There's a lot of sparkles, it feels like a lot of love, a lot of sensitivity, a lot of softness. That inner part of you that is almost, how would I say it? I don't know if I want to use the word misty, but it's so rarefied and so refined and so sparkly. It's that part of self. And what this feels like to me is nurturing and protecting that part of yourself. So she's, the fairy that's sitting here on the rocks is sitting like this, and kind of like in a protective manner, and she's sitting on rocks. I don't know how well you can see that. And that to me means being grounded and allowing that sensitive part of yourself to be grounded. So it's hard to feel safe when you're very sensitive if you don't have some sort of grounding and link to the earth, is what I'm getting. So the more you can ground yourself, the better off you're gonna be. So if you don't feel safe a lot of times, and or you feel maybe unsure because you're so sensitive, grounding is going to help you a lot. I always like to do the tree exercise for grounding, and I probably need to do another video on that. But that's where you visualize your roots going down into the earth, like deep, deep, deep down. Visualize it going out of your foot chakras and go into the earth, into the crystals down there, and then wait for the energy to come back up. And then you allow branches to come out of your head and go up into the ethers, way up past your house, past your city, up into above earth, into the universe. And allow your leaves to gather the cosmic energy and allow that energy to come back down and to meet in your middle. So you connect upward and you connect below. And that's a grounding thing I like to do all the time. I feel much better when I do it. So let's move into the second card. So you know what I just realized? I did the grounding exercise and the last weekly video that I did. I didn't do last week's video because I had like 5,000 things happening, but the last video in the weekly Oracle card playlist that I have. I have the tree grounding exercise. So the second card is Fairy Tales, Letting Go, Detachment, and Moving On. Okay, so one of the things I'm feeling is that this part of you that's sensitive here, this is the part that can tell what's right and not right for you. It's the part that can tell what's love and not love, what is authentic for you and not authentic for you. And it's this part, if you can be more centered with it and have it grounded in your body, it'll be easier for you to let go of things that are not serving you and that are not helping you. Because this card is about letting go of like detachment and desperatelessness and, you know, other frequencies that don't need to be there. So in this card, the man, he almost looks like he's drowning a little bit and the woman is walking away. And I know this card says fairy tales. I love this card dearly, but I don't feel like it should say fairy tales. I feel like it should say like illusionment. Wait, that's not a word. Illusions or something to the nature of that. Because a lot of times with fairy tales, we think of like magical love and da 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 da. And I know what this card is meaning is illusions. Let go of illusions, let go of detachment and whatever. So I really do wish this card was named a little different. So, because the energy of it is, you know, let go of what's not serving you. So if you're hanging on to something, it's probably because in your mind or in your emotional body, you think that you need that thing and you've got to have that thing and you need to be attached to that thing. And really it's an illusion, you don't, right? So this part of you, your psychic part of you, your intuitive part of you, your magical part of you, that part of you that operates in those different dimensions is the one that's really going to be able to be discerning and be like, you know what, that's not I don't need that. That's not true for me. It's not true that I need to continue to keep this situation in my life to be happy. It's not true that I need to continue to pander to this person in order to have my life be okay. It's not true. You know, I have inner power. I can let them go and have healthier relationships in my life, and everything will be just fine, right? Like, I don't need that attachmentness. So the next one is Beauty and the Beast, Unconditional Love. So in this card, we have the woman, and she's got these little like green creatures behind her. Maybe they're goblins. I'm not really sure. But they represent, at least to me when I look at the card, it represents, it's like ego fears, right? So have the courage to not be disillusioned by your ego fears. And if each goblin, one, two, three, four, five, there's five of them in here. If each of them represent one of your ego's fears, you know, don't get pulled down by your inner goblins, because your inner goblins are the ones that are going to keep telling you that you have to have these attachments and da-da-da-da-da-da. But your heart over here is going to be like, no, you don't. You don't need that. It's not necessary. Okay? So that's really what I'm feeling from this card, is to be more in your inner power. This card is also green, which is reminding me of like the heart chakra, the heart space, being in authentic alignment with you. Seeing what's true, right? So in Beauty and the Beast, the cartoon, from, I'm not really sure when that came out, I guess the 90s, you know, there's Belle, and there's the, big, fuzzy, hairy beast guy, right? And, the truth is that he's actually this handsome prince inside, but he believes himself to be this big beast, and so he, has this outwardly he changes into a beast, right? So he, based on his inner thoughts and things, his reality shows that to him in the cartoon by him actually being a beast, but it's not really true. And unconditional love dissolves that, okay? So if you have parts of yourself that believe themselves to be unlovable, whatever, any sort of like lower frequency, sending that part of yourself unconditional love, like Belle did in the cartoon, transforms it. So you can send your inner goblins unconditional love and be centered and grounded in that unconditional love, and your goblins will disintegrate. But irregardless, don't believe what they say, right? So a lot of times when you send your inner goblins or your ego's fears unconditional love, what you're basically saying is, I know, that's lovely, thanks for the information, but I know a higher truth, and so I'm going to allow your fears to disintegrate, because I know love is more powerful than fear. And so then you ground in your authenticness and your you ground in your true self, right? And you allow those things that no longer serve you to go away, because you don't feel powerless against them, because you know that they're not true, because you know that they're just fears and attachments and so forth, and you know that love will transform them. You send them love and just allow them to transform, okay? So, anyway, all right, so this week is about standing in your truth. It's about not getting bogged down with other people's shoulds or your ego's attachments to things or how it thinks things should be. It's about grounding in more of your authentic self, being connected to the earth, being connected up above, standing in your authentic truth, doing what you think is right for you, and moving more into your heart space and being grounded and centered. Alright, you guys, I hope you have a wonderful week and happy 4th of July if you are in the United States. And I will see all of you guys next week. Alright, goodbye.